In this video, we'll go over freshness in dbt that you can use to test and check your sources to make sure that they are as updated or fresh as you expect them to be. Freshness will ultimately be a block of code that we can add to an entire source or to individual tables as well. Here in Visual Studio, I have a source file that's reflecting a table that I made that's just called my favorite source. And if we go in Snowflake, it looks something like this. It's just very simple, a name, a created at column, a timestamp column. And then I have a column here that I added to just let me know how long has it been since this record has been inserted. So we can see here all these were inserted into this table about 20 minutes ago. Now what we want to do is test this table to make sure that it's as updated as we expect it to be. You know, maybe 21 minutes is too long. You know, man, we want to be flagged when it crosses, let's say, 15 minutes or something. In this case, we're going to base it off of this created at. If we scroll down to an example, there's two places you can do this. You can do this on this level here above the tables, which means that any table within this will be tested with the same settings here. But maybe you have some specific criteria for an individual table, or you just want this to test on one table in your file. You could do it there as well. I'll copy this into ours, and we're going to just do it on the whole schema. It doesn't matter for our case because there's only one table. So let's review this. So now let's review the syntax here of what's going on. We have our freshness block. That's where you indicate that this is what's going on here. When we run this source freshness, when do we want this to warn us and when do we want it to error? And here's where we can set that. Count and period go hand in hand. So in this case, this is saying warn us after 12 hours and error after 24 hours. In our case, if we remember, it was about 20 minutes since they were uploaded. So let's say we want it to warn after 20 minutes and error after 30 minutes. This can be either day, minute, or hour. Loaded at field. What field are we looking at here? What are we basing this off of? In our case, like we said, we will use this created at field. So I'll put that there. Now, the last option is filter. We'll touch on that in a little bit. Now, the command we want to run is dbt source snapshot freshness. And what this is going to do is look through your project and identify any place where this freshness block exists. And if it exists, it's going to compile some SQL and run it as if it were a test. So let's run this. And we can see this failed. But if we look in Snowflake, it's only been 27 minutes. So why did that fail? And the reason this failed is because this loaded at field is expecting a UTC value. In my case, my Snowflake setting is not UTC. And to check what yours is, you can run this code right here. If you're on Snowflake, show parameters like time zone. And mine is set to Los Angeles, so it's in Pacific time zone, but dbt is comparing it to UTC, so it's out of whack. That's why it made it seem like it's so much further out. And what they recommend here is they say, if using a non-UTC timestamp, cast it to UTC first. And that's what we'll do here. But what we'll want to do, this is actually backwards for us. We want this to go from not UTC to LA. We want it to go from Los Angeles to UTC. And so what this will do is then compare this converted timestamp, which will now be converted to UTC, against the current time in UTC. So now let's run this again. And now we see that it's warning. That's because it's less than 50, but greater than 30. Now, if we said we want warn to be 1 hour and error to be 2 hour, we would expect this to pass now. And it does. The time zone is something you need to be aware of if you're not already using a UTC timestamp. If you are, then you don't have to worry about that. And then the count and period allows you to adjust how you want this to be tested. Now, the last part we'll touch on that we haven't already is this filter component here. And this will be used in that compiled SQL. Essentially, it's just going to take whatever you put here and add it as a where clause. And the reason you would want to have this to help with performance and make sure you're not, you know, returning unnecessary records to compare when it really doesn't matter. So first, what I'm going to do is insert some new records to give us something new to compare to. So now if I do this and we compare, we can see 44 and then 0. So let's add this filter, and the filter will go right below the warn after and error after. In their case, they did this. Let's do, instead of day, let's do minute, where it's less than 40. And we'll do that so that we can, you know, prevent us from looking at these. And with that being said, we can say warn us if greater than 1 minute, but less than 5 minutes. Without this filter, we would expect this to error because we have all of those records that are over 40 minutes that would error this. But with this filter, we're now excluding those and saying, of that remaining set, run this test. So let's try it. And we get warn, which is what we would expect because at this point, this is greater than one. They're now at 2. We do 5 and 10. This is likely to pass. So that's how you can use the filter to actually trim down your data set, help with performance. You can make this as complicated as you want because all it's really going to do is add it as a where clause. So lastly, what I'll do is show you, you know, where this information is stored and how this is working under the hood a little bit. So like many other things, we'll go to the target folder here. And you'll get a new object called sources.json. And if we open this up, I'll format it. This is where it's storing information about your latest run, your latest source freshness test, so to speak. You can see the max loaded at time in seconds. So that's really where it's taking the results of those queries, storing it, looking at the difference and saying, did it pass, fail? What was this based off of? What are their conditions? And this will break it down for each source individually. Right now, we only have it for one, but if you had many, you would see all of those here. And you could hop in here and just, you know, get a quick pulse on where things were, what happened, when was the last time it ran, etc. That'll do it for this video. I think source freshness can be a really helpful tool, especially if you have strict SLAs on how updated some sources need to be, or you just want to keep a pulse on it for yourself. This is a great built-in way to do this, and it's pretty straightforward and easy to use once you understand, you know, the basics of the code block. As always, thank you for watching. If you found this helpful, feel free to like the video, leave a comment. I'll try to answer your questions, and subscribe if you'd like to see some more content like this as well. Thanks again, and I'll see you at the next video.